The year 2020 was really a big challenge for everyone in the world, with pandemics, lockdowns, unemployments, yeah, the list really goes on. But what's interesting is that the scientists around the world were able to develop a vaccine within 7 months. Not just one, but 6 vaccines were approved in different countries. Meanwhile, there are only 25 diseases in the United States yet to have an approved vaccine. And speaking about COVID vaccines, the development of vaccine from Moderna and BioNTech Pfizer is a giant leap in the production of vaccines. Scientists were able to produce genetic codes that would program our body to produce the spike proteins of SARS-CoV-2. With 6 different approved vaccines, it might be in our best interest to know the different types and variants of vaccines. At this point, there are over 223 vaccine candidates submitted to the WHO, in which more than 57 are in clinical trials. Each company has their own unique and innovative approach in the production of vaccines that ranges from genetic engineering to injecting live and non-infectious coronaviruses to our body. In this video, let's take a look at the different types of vaccines in production. There are 4 types of COVID-19 vaccines. First, the genetic vaccine, which uses mRNA to synthesize viral proteins. Then the vaccine from the Oxford University and British firm AstraZeneca, which uses DNA with the help of adenovirus as a vector. The third vaccine uses spike proteins as a material. And finally, we have the vaccine which uses inactive coronaviruses to generate immunity. First things first, let's take a look at the newly developed vaccine which uses mRNA to induce immunity in our body. To understand how these vaccines work, we have to take a look at how SARS-CoV-2 infects humans. SARS coronaviruses are made up of 25 different proteins, and one of them on the outer surface folds to form a spike. These spikes look for special receptors on our body and attach to them. The impressive thing of these viruses are that they don't have to enter into the human cells to infect them, but simply attaching to the receptors will enable them to take over the cell infrastructure. The virus then uses the cell infrastructure to produce new coronaviruses upon command. To fight back, our body produces special cells that will attach itself to the spikes of the coronavirus, thus preventing it from infecting new cells. Wow, that was really a mouthful of science. Now for the vaccine part. Geniuses from the German company BioNTech, together with the pharma giant Pfizer, made use of the genetic engineering technology to create RNA which could help in the production of immune cells against the COVID-19. This idea was only available in papers, but millions of dollars donated by governments and billionaires around the world, companies were able to develop a vaccine which will enable cells to produce viral spike proteins and train our immune cells. The advantage of this new tech is that our body only have to deal with the production of spike proteins, thus eliminating the problems of the traditional vaccine. The harder part of this tech is that the samples must be transported in a cold storage in which the temperature ranges from minus 70 to 30 degrees Celsius. This difficulty leads us to the next type of vaccines, commonly known as Oxford vaccines. The Oxford University and companies like Bharat Biotech and AstraZeneca were able to develop a vaccine where they use genetic materials to produce spike proteins and is stored in the viral vector. This method will significantly reduce the difficulties in storages. Jabs, which would cost about $2 to $5, can be stored in normal refrigerators. This technique uses harmless and weakened adenoviruses that usually causes common cold in chimpanzees. The DNA that corresponds to the production of COVID-19 spikes are filled into these monkey viruses and are injected to our body. Once in our body, these adenoviruses give signals to the production of spike proteins of coronaviruses that could indeed trigger an immune response against SARS-CoV-2. The best thing here is that the DNA sequences that needed to the replication of adenoviruses are removed before injection. Thus, viruses eventually dies out as our immune cells detects the virus and kills it. In my opinion, this method might be the best option for people who belong to the risk categories like babies, elderly, or people with severe health conditions, as there are enough health data regarding the response of adenovirus in our body. Stay tuned for the next video about the biggest vaccination program in the human history, where 1.4 billion people are being vaccinated in India using this technique of adenoviruses. The most number of vaccines in the United Kingdom and probably around the world uses viral subunits to induce immunity in our body. This is also true for COVID vaccines. 30% of all the candidates in the clinical trial uses subunits, but unfortunately none of them have got any approval to be used even in emergency situations. This type, which uses traditional methods to develop, must undergo a large variety of safety and production standard checks. So, we might not be seeing any of those anytime sooner in our market. So, let's ignore them and move on to the next type of COVID-19 vaccines. The Chinese companies were brave enough to produce vaccines which involve real coronaviruses. The CoronaVax from Sinovac is making use of inactive coronaviruses to produce vaccines. Scientists have collected live coronaviruses and have cultivated them in labs. These viruses have undergone many processes that ensures that the virus will lose all its ability to infect human cells. Sometimes, viruses are also treated with high heat to ensure further safety. The vaccine, which was allowed to use in emergency situation back in the July of 2019 in China, has an efficiency rate of 85%. Today, CoronaVax is officially approved in the Singapore and many other Latin American countries. There are also a couple of other methods to produce coronavirus vaccines. These include jabs with live viruses or with viral-like particles, but unfortunately, none of them have made into the phase 1 of clinical trials. So I am not going to introduce them in this video. Thanks for watching. Have a great day. Ciao.